What's up, bitches? Welcome back to World 1-1 Podcast. I'm Larry, the Nordic Wonder. Some call me Tim. With us, we have Eddie the Chocolate Thunder Wonder from Down Under V. We've also got a special guest today, back with us yet again, Lord of the Panty Drop, Tony Zilikakis.
Hello.
And your hostess with the mostest, the man himself, Pure Canada, Pure Maple, Adrian!
Hello.
This is already going to hell. How's everyone doing today?
Doing good.
Great.
Better now that we're not full of technical problems. You missed all that shit.
Oh, really?
Oh, God, it was a mess.
Pretty bad.
Hear myself again, though.
Yeah, there's a bad echo.
Oh, all right.
Okay. On air sound check.
Just so everybody knows how podcasts go, there's always something happening here.
We're definitively not professional. We're just fun.
Yeah, exactly. Well, anyway, welcome everyone. Very happy to be here again. I'm going to take this train wreck again of hosting. That's something that I don't usually do. But because I'm... I don't know. I like topics, so I took some topics for myself, and we're going to go with that. The first topic for today is something we missed a couple of weeks ago. And Larry talked about possible Super Smash Bros. Arcade list of characters. They all went through their characters. Most of them were awful. Like, awful, awful. Really, what were you guys thinking? But I came up with a list of really cool stuff.
I told you what I was thinking when I put my list up.
Yeah, I guess you did. Yeah, I like your indie picks though. Those were really cool. I think Tim. I think you mentioned Tim from Braid. I think he could have some really cool, interesting stuff on the Smash for sure. But anyway, so the first game I chose is of course. One of my favorite N64 games, which is Banjo-Kazooie. I'm the roster just right itself. It's going to be a combo of Banjo-Kazooie, just like the Ice Climbers. Mumbo Jumbo, because in Banjo-Tooie you could play as him, and I think he could like just transform you with his B or something into very different things. I think that would be really cool. Grootilda, of course, we need a villain there. She can be a heavy character, just like Bowser or something. Maybe with a very good air recovery because of her broom and stuff. Another heavy character, I forgot his name, but I just call him Igor, which is the guy that helps Grootilda during the game. He can be another heavy character as well, very ground-based, very slow, but like really strong at the same time. So that's the first game. The second game, it's something that we talked about, I think it was last week, from Mystical Ninja that came out on the Wii U eShop. I got Goemon's Greatest Adventure with it, which is another favorite N64 title. So all the main characters from that game. So Goemon, Yae, Sasuke, and Ebisumaru. So all the four main characters. They all have different weapons and different fighting styles. So I think they will make a really cool Smash pick. From Sonic, of course, the entire Sonic team. So Sonic, Amy, Knuckles, and Tails. I mean, why not? Why aren't they on the Smash already? From Mega Man. Sorry?
Sonic already is.
Yeah, well, I'm not on the list that Eddie sent. It's just like these four Mario characters that nobody cares about. And then I was like, well, I'm adding Sonic. So I'm adding Sonic again.
I don't know about Amy and Tails, but I would totally be down with Knuckles. Knuckles is the fucking bomb.
Knuckles will be really fun, actually, yeah. Well, Amy has her hammer, so I think she can be really interesting. I don't know. And Tails will be, like, a very light character, but his recovery will be just like Kirby or Jigglypuff. He, like, flies a lot. think it will be really fun.
I call bullshit. There's no Biggs the Cat.
Oh, God.
We're going to excuse that one from the list.
Sorry?
Big the Cat. No.
Nope. I agree. Nope. Nothing's happening with him. From the Man series, X, of course, Zero, and Axel. Just because I think Axel is not very popular, and I think making him into Smash will attract more people back into the Mega Man series, and that will be awesome, because we may get a Mega Man X9 if that arcade cabinet sells well in Japan or something. And for last of that like Mega Man franchise list, either, again, classic Mega Man, or which will play very differently from X, because they're very different in-game already, or another villain, we can bring Sigma. Sigma has changed so much between the X series that I think his powers will be like all over the place. Tony, what do you think about that? Like, will you put classic Mega Man or Sigma?
I would put Sigma.
Yeah?
Yeah. Because I think that he could probably like change his forms depending on like what moves you're doing, so that he fights like the first form from the different games.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I think he will be like a really cool choice for sure. So coming up, continuing with the list, another franchise that is very important to me from the Game Boy Advance era is Golden Sun. There's so many cool characters on that RPG, and if you put like just one character of that franchise on the Smash, it will bring back love to the series, just like Martha and Roy did for Fire Emblem back in the day on Melee. So, of course, you have to put Isaac, which is the main character of the first game. You put Ivan, which is like a Wing Adept type dude on the first game. He will be like a very light character, but super fast. I think he will be super interesting. Alex, which is the main villain of, spoilers, the entire trilogy. And he will like teleport all over the place and use like water techniques and stuff like that. That would be really cool. And either Saturus or Menardi, which are the, I guess, the main villains of the first game. They're like these fire type dudes. They're really strong and stuff like that. So maybe they will make a good, either like a combo team type thing, or just either one of them will be like a really powerful. From the Pokemon franchise, you have to put Pikachu and Jigglypuff. Of course, you have to put them. I will bring back Greninja, because I think a lot of people like Greninja already. There was a poll in Japan, and he was the most popular Pokemon in the franchise. I think Pikachu was, like, third. So, I mean, just bring Greninja back, I guess. And Blaziken, because he's one of my favorite Pokemons from... Well, he's my only Pokemon that I like from Gen 3. Even though I think Tony hates this stupid chicken.
I do. I hate it.
Yeah, sorry, but I love Blaziken.
So now, Blaziken is... one trainer come back?
Maybe.
I really loved Pokemon Trainer back in Brawl.
Yeah, I mean, the Pokemon Trainer was really fun. It was... You know what? Like, I would actually prefer the three characters to be their own thing. Like, a Squirtle, Ivysaur, and Charizard to be three different characters, rather than having the Pokemon Trainer switch between them, because it was kind of annoying sometimes. Like, I only liked playing with Squirtle, and I had to like switch between all the other two in order to get Squirtle again whenever I died. That was kind of a pain in the butt. But yeah, maybe Pokemon Trainer can be on the maybe list there. From Earthbound, we need more Earthbound on the Smash Brother. So Ness and Lucas for sure, and I will bring Jeff. Because I think with all his mechanic stuff, he will make like really cool gadgets for Smash. And Paula, maybe, because with her like psychic powers, she will be like more psychic based than Ness already is in the Smash. She will have like a bunch of really far away attacks that are like super strong. Again, Tony, what do you think of that Earthbound list?
I would dump Lucas because I'm not the biggest fan of his character. I would just put the four main characters from Earthbound, really. Because they're each actually, like, different stat-wise. So, like, yeah. Ness is mostly physical. Paula's mostly psychic. Jeff is all on his own with his, you know, items and stuff. And then Pooh is like the middle between psychic and physical attack. So it's like they would all play differently. He'd probably be speed based if anything, but
maybe he can have like the like his final smash can be
Sorry, this is not what you guys are talking about right now, but Starstorm does not belong on NES. That belongs to Pooh. It doesn't belong to Lucas either. That has bugged me.
I remember that play in Earthbound. I was like, oh, hold on, he doesn't have this attack, but he does on his match.
He doesn't have fire, he doesn't have thunder. That it makes no sense, his moves in Smash. Except for Flash. Flash is the only one that he has.
Yeah. Maybe if they add the entire roster from Earthbound, they can change Ness a lot, and he will play like completely different, but it would be really interesting for sure.
Yeah.
That's for Earthbound. And the only thing wrong with Eddie's initial Smash arcade structure is that he broke the most important rule from Smash, which is you always have to have the main characters from the first game. So you need Kirby, you need Samus, you need Captain Falcon, you need Fox, you need Link, Donkey Kong, and Yoshi. I already added Pikachu and Jigglypuff there, and Mario was already in the game too. So you need all those characters, and I know I went over the character limit list, but if you don't have the main characters from the first match, then this Smash Arcade will just fail. And that's my list.
But you were supposed to create your own arcade. So it doesn't matter if, it really doesn't matter. It's your own personal list. It's your own arcade. You have the chance to work with Nintendo to make it.
My own arcade, I still have the original roster, Smash Brothers and N64. Because I'm like weird.
You know, Adrian, your list made me realize I totally fucking missed something that I should have had on there. I should have had a sect of game on there that I didn't.
Which?
Chrono Trigger.
I actually thought of the Trigger, especially since Cloud is in Smash now. I'm not super familiar with the franchise, so I will own Chrono in the game. Both people that really and like have played multiple times, they can probably like a really good list. They told it that I always forget his name. I think his name was Silver for sure. What do you guys think of it? Alright, good.
I like the list. I think you felt more at home with, you know, your standard Nintendo stuff and, you know, some deviation on there. I wanted to take the opportunity to deviate out completely and just, you know, leave the base Mario shit on there.
Yeah, you know what, like, I was thinking about that when I was coming up with the list and when I heard your, both of your lists there. My problem was, like, I feel like Smash is a combination of Nintendo culture and it's just expanding to some other areas. So I tried putting as much Nintendo culture as possible, and I think I did a pretty decent job for the most part.
Well, it's
like maybe Axel from Mega Man X was kind of like a stretch there, but like everything else for the most part has appeared on a Nintendo platform.
Well, that's the thing about it, Adrian. It didn't have to. You could have picked any video series.
I know. This was, if I was building this Smash cabinet, that's what I would put, though. Like, that's how I will feel about it. I will still try to make it as much Nintendo as possible.
But why? That's my question, is why? Why, if you're open...
That's what he wants to play.
I know, but I guess I'm trying to figure out if you're able to have free reign on putting different games from different platforms that's not on Nintendo into a Smash game. Like, why wouldn't you not choose any of those games? Not saying that your list is wrong or anything, but like, if you have the opportunity to actually put like any game, like any choice. It didn't all have to be Nintendo related.
Well, the thing is that like I was looking at games that I have played and I really like from other French like other platforms and stuff like that. And there wasn't something like there wasn't anything that I thought will fit well on the Smash as a Smash overall. So I don't know. I just went with it. I was gonna put Shovel Knight, but then Larry had Shovel Knight in there, and your picks were actually really good. So I just thought.
We put in Shovel Knight.
Yeah. Well, exactly. You put Shovel Knight, and I like I'm on board with your list. So I just didn't put it on mine because I think you did an amazing job with the list. You also had a bunch of like indie characters that I think will fit like very well in a Smash. So.
Yeah.
Yep. But anyways, moving on to the next topic here. So I couldn't sleep a couple nights ago, and I was just trying to think of what type of media will help me sleep the best. I'm usually watching like YouTube videos on my phone or my computer until I fall asleep, but that's entertainment, so it takes me like a long while to like actually get tired and fall asleep. So I just wanted to take it to you guys and maybe just mention something you do, like books or music or video games or movies, whatever, that helps you, basically helps you sleep during the night or whenever you can really fall asleep quickly. So Eddie, why don't you go first? What do you have there?
I have the Secret of Mana arrangement. There's a group called I actually have two of them. There's a thing called Mana for Sleep, and they're from two composers called Gentle Love. And these composers, they work in the video game industry. I'm trying to get their name. Noriko Hiko Hibano, best known for his work on the Metal Gear Solid series and Bayonetta. He founded Hibano Sound Therapy Lab, and they take a video game music and make it very therapeutic, like a real acoustic versions of it. So all you get is piano and horn. That's all you get for it. And they did one for Secret of Mana, and it's so relaxing when you hear it. Like, it literally puts you to sleep. Like, it's an hour's worth of music that you could just throw on and be knocked out. If I'm not doing music like that, video game music, I am watching YouTube videos of massages. And so I will watch, like, sometimes the
trailer
of massages. Yeah, and they're so relaxing. Watching them that sometimes I just end up falling asleep and then my computer will cut off. So those two will do it. If I'm doing any kind of late gaming, mostly I'll just get tired and cut it off and just go to sleep. But, you know, to really knock me out, I would just like do massage videos, or I would do like the Mana for Sleep or the Prescription for Sleep. And they're really good. Yeah, they're really good albums if you're very interested.
That sounds really cool. You'll have to send me. Well, we'll link a that group that you mentioned on the podcast, so we can like check it out later for sure.
Yeah,
and everybody that is listening can check it out for sure as well. Maybe I'm still looking for things that help me sleep. So, all right, what about you, Larry? What media helps you sleep?
Let's see. Game.
Well, you're at that, so I'm pretty sure that whenever you're asleep, you just go to sleep. No,
I'd be surprised actually. Like lately, some of the nights that I've gotten the worst nights of sleep are when Christine and Olivia are actually sleeping solid through the night.
Interesting.
Like they'll be passed the fuck out. I'm wide the hell awake. But if it's games, playing through like Prime 1. Is a good one, because that's one that I can just kind of turn my brain off because I know it inside and out. I don't ever have to think about that game, ever. Bastion's been really good for that lately. I've kind of been rediscovering that. That's been a very mild, relaxing game for me. Like, I know it's not really intended to be, but it's got this sort of really calm, mellow about it that I like.
Yeah, play on Raiders. Okay, fine. Very calm.
Yeah. As far as listening, I'm a big fan of escapepod.org, actually. I'll put on a handful of their stories on a playlist and just pass out. They do, and here's a free plug for them because these guys are awesome. They totally deserve it. They do free short or free weekly short science fiction audio podcast stuff. Really, really great stories. Wonderful stuff. And if you guys have never checked it out, go check them out. They're amazing. And on top of that, all props to them. They pay all their authors, and they put out all their stuff for free. They're all donation only.
That's awesome. That's really cool.
They've got some phenomenal stuff.
Send me a link to that as well.
Definitely. They've got a couple of sister shows, too, which I'm not nuts about, but it's just because it's not as much my flavor. They've got a horror podcast called Pseudopod, and they've got a fantasy one called Podcastle. So, but in any case, if I'm watching something, it's usually something like short episodic stuff. And usually it's something that I've seen a ton before, so it's just background noise for me. Archer is always really good for me because I'll kind of funny joke, and then I'll start to sleep a little more funny joke. And I'm okay falling asleep because I know I've seen all of it, and it doesn't bother me. That or, you know, some of the YouTube stuff. It just depends on what kind of mood I'm in. Like watching through a full Let's Play of something. Stuff like the React videos, actually. Because I'll wake up throughout the night, and it's still running. I'll kind of, you know, wake up and watch one or two and nod back off again, and I'm good. So, MXC on Hulu's been really good for that lately, too, actually. Which, God, I love MXC. Somebody bring that show back.
MXC, what that is?
Most Extreme Challenge.
Most Extreme Elimination Challenge. Hell yes. Like, if you've ever seen that show Wipeout, MXC is kind of where that shit came from.
So, it's Japanese people doing these crazy challenges. And when it came to America, they were doing these funny overdubs. It was on Spike TV. And when you watch it, it's completely one of those martial arts 60 movies that the dubbing is so bad, like the lips don't match up. And they do like certain replays of stuff, and it's completely hilarious.
I used to love that show.
Yes.
I have fond memories of watching that show with my dad, actually. I adore MXC.
Yeah, and Hulu has the whole series on it.
Yeah, they do. 5 seasons, baby. Get some.
That's awesome.
I thought you were pretty cool. I'll check that out, too, because I love Wipeout. So.
Yeah, MXC is way better than Wipeout.
Right. And the voices are so funny.
Sorry?
Oh, the voices
are there. I'll throw in one more real quick. On the music side, one of my favorite soundtracks to fall asleep to, which I haven't in a long time, but there was a compilation of remixes put together from Super Metroid called Reserve Tank Variations. And it was really good. It had a lot of really chill, mellow, atmospheric stuff that's just spectacular. And if you go out to the Metroid Database website, I think you can still find a link to it there somewhere on their music section. So totally check that shit out.
For sure.
If I can find the link again, I'll put it up on the Facebook page.
Yeah, we'll link all this stuff. Tony, how are you? What type of media help you like sleep?
I can't put on a show. I can't eat Netflix. I can't do music even. All that will make my brain, my gear turn, and I won't be able to fall asleep. The way I sleep, literally every night, I put on a Let's Play. I just have my TV. And both of them had to turn off, like, inactivity. So, they're off
time I wake up. They knock me out. Actually, one place that I put on because Flyers playing Five Brady series, even though it like has all like scare noises and stuff, that'll put me to sleep quick.
Hold on, guys. Yes, Tony? I mean, yes, Larry? Is okay. Give me 1 second. I'm actually going to stop it.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, that grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life.
So this is the part of the show where all the technology broke, and so instead of leaving you with an abrupt gap or stop, I thought I'd bring you this cheery classical tune for you to enjoy for a few minutes while we got our shit back together. So here you go.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Come on.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow.
So always look on the bright side of death. Just before you draw your terminal breath.
A piece of shit when you look at it. Life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show. Keep them laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the right side of life.
Records available in the foyer.
Always look on the right.
Some of us got to live as well, you know. All right, it's a lot. Let's get this place up there.
Always look on the right.
And change his mantle within 3 weeks. What do you think pays for all this rubbish?
Always look on the
right. I never made the money back, you know. I told him. I said to him, Bernie, I said, they'll never make that money back.
Thank you very much for coming along. Thank you very much for coming along. I think the voiceovers have helped the record enormously.
That's it, is it? I mean, that really is it?
Yes, thanks. That's all we need, thanks.
Okay. We don't want the song, then?
No, this song is a bit de trop, I think. We have plenty of songs on the album anyway, as it happens. Is
who?
£30 all right?
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to World 101 Podcast. Continuing our discussion about media that help us go to sleep, I'm going to hand it back over to our good friend, Adrian Nieto. Adrian?
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. Sorry about we had a little technical glitch there. But we're back. We were talking about media that helps us to sleep, whether that be books, movies, music, video games, YouTube videos, whatever have you. So Tony was going to take it away. So Tony, what were you saying before?
Basically, music doesn't help. That'll keep me awake. TV shows, Netflix, video games, all that'll keep me awake. The one thing that puts me to sleep, like, right away is just putting on a Let's Play. I use my Wii U, have YouTube up on my TV. They both are set to turn off after, like, an hour of inactivity, something like that. So they're off by the time I wake up. And usually I'll put on a Let's Play by, like, a good one that I use is, like, Markiplier when he plays Five Nights at Freddy's. Even though it has, like, all the, like, loud jump scare sounds, doesn't faze me at all. I'm already asleep by the time the first kill happens.
Nice. That's actually not that bad.
I wonder what would happen if you did a Let's Play of Flower for PS3.
Flower, what is that?
That will be too dull, though. That will probably make me fall asleep right away.
Well, that's the purpose.
Well, yeah, I guess so. That's very true. So, the reason, again, why I asked this question was because I woke up, like, in the middle of the night. I was trying to get my sleep back, and it was going terribly. I couldn't really fall asleep. I tried pretty much everything that I normally try from YouTube. I've been watching a lot of Mario Maker videos of, like, Kaiser races or, like, puzzle levels and stuff like that. That didn't help, that is actually really entertaining. So instead of falling asleep, I was just, like, following along and wanted to play some more Mario Maker. Video games, for the most part, I normally get hooked, and I just play more rather than going to sleep. So that's always out of the question. Netflix, again, like, it does help. I have an Apple TV, and the good thing about that is it plays, like, 4 episodes, or it plays, like, 2 hours worth of content, I shall say, before he asks you, hey, are you still watching? And normally by the time that message hits, I'm already asleep, and my Apple TV just goes into, like, a sleep mode after 5 minutes of inactivity when that message appears, and then my TV, like, shuts itself off after 10 minutes of that message. So, like, everything is off, just like Tony, right? Like, everything is off by the time I wake up, then it's perfect. I can just turn my TV back on and click play again, and it just continues on where I left out, basically. But, like, that wasn't really helping that night. And I was just, like, going all over the place, just trying to find, like, one thing that will really help me fall asleep. And then I remember that I have, on my beautiful phone, I have the audiobook of Ready Player One, which is my favorite, like, video game related book. Actually, no, scratch that. It's my favorite book. And the audiobook is really good. So I was just listening to that, which, again, I've listened to, like, 5 times already, and I've read the book, like, twice as well. So I was just listening to that, and that really helped me fall asleep. So that was really fun. If you have any piece of media that helps you sleep, just email us at world11podcast@gmail.com. Let us know what you use to fall asleep.
You know what? Lately, I've been doing zero punctuation on YouTube. I just, like, put it on the playlist and laugh, but then fall asleep when all the Nintendo stuff come on. It's so weird.
Yeah.
You know, shockingly, Hulu's got zero punctuation up on Hulu.
Really?
Seriously, and I just realized that's a horribly redundant fucking sentence. Hulu has zero punctuation on Hulu. Wow.
I listened to that script. I was going to say it. And I was like, nah.
That's the endorsement money coming in right there. Every time I say Hulu, you hear ka-ching.
Ching-ching.
We get 1 cent.
I know. I need some money. I got to go get my 2-piece and a biscuit still.
There you go. So, if any of you have any piece of, like, media that helps you sleep, let us know, because I'm still looking for things that help me sleep. But that brings us to our last point of today's show, which is Nintendo just announced this week a very, very interesting piece of machine, which is I've been calling it the NES Mini, although everybody calls it like something different. It's basically a small box that fits in the palm of your hand, and it has 30 pre-installed games. It's an amazing list of NES games from back in the day, and has like a controller that also can connect to a Wiimote, so you can play on your Wii U some of those classic games using that remote instead of like a Pro controller or anything like that. And it's gonna be out, I think November, if I'm not mistaken. And the price is $60. So I'm very excited about that. Everybody that I talk to is super excited about that. Like, including my sister, who doesn't really play video games. She wants one of those. And that made me, like, super happy, because I've always tried to look for ways to connect with my siblings. They're very different from me, but they're very alike between themselves.
And people are already asking me questions when I'm going to get it at my job. I'm like, I don't know. When it comes in, I'm like, they're just the nicest thing.
A lot of people are really looking forward to it, and I plan to get one and just put it on my office. That way, whenever I'm like tired or something, I can just like, you know, get it out, play, I don't know, like a run of Mario or something, and then go back to work. I think it's really gonna help my productivity further. But I asked the question on the main NBC group, basically asking, hey, if you had a Super Nintendo Mini that Nintendo was gonna produce next, which games would you like to have on that console? And someone said something very important, which is the Super Nintendo wouldn't really have 30 games, mostly because of the price of this stuff. So they will probably reduce the either increase the price of the mini console, or put like just 15 games instead of 30. So I really like that idea, and a lot of people gave me like some really cool ideas for games. Actually, like 48 entries in total. So our job today is we're gonna get from that 48 game list, we're gonna bring it down to 15, and that's gonna be our official Super Nintendo Mini list, if Nintendo were to produce this. So the rules are very simple. I'm gonna read each game. We all get like a yes or no. If one of us says no, the game just disappears from the list. However, if we go under 15, then we'll go around the table as well, and each one of us is gonna be able to add one to the list, as long as we are all in agreement that that game deserves to be in the list. So the first game is A Link to the Legend of Zelda: A Link to the Past. What do you guys think? Should that be on the list or no?
No.
Obligatory.
Yeah, okay. That one, it's a must.
Okay, why do you say no, Eddie?
I think there's better Super Nintendo games for role playing. And plus, I think a lot of people already played The Legend of Zelda: A Link to the Past. So I wouldn't put
this,
it on.
But this
there.
Is not about most. No, hold on. This is not about most people. This is about like a new generation of people playing this game for the first
time. That's the thing about it, because there's already Link to the Past has already came out. Like, if you play the Wii, you have already played it. So there wouldn't be no reason of putting it on something like that. On a little box like that. Like, it's already been played. A lot of people have talked about it. A lot of people know about it. So I wouldn't put it on.
Wouldn't you say the exact same thing about the entire library that's on that NES Mini? That's why I'm not interested in it, is because I already have almost all those games.
I didn't get to see the list. I gotta still see the list.
It's like 30 NES Essentials, basically. You know,
they're all the essentials.
Zelda's and Mario 1, 2, and 3. And
Metroid, Castlevania 1 and 2, Mega Man 2. It's all the essentials.
Yeah. It's basically the
beginner's guide to NES. Yeah, I would still say no to it. I think there's like Soul Blazer is something like I will put on, like something of an RPG that we haven't really talked about or really played. You know, and I think the Link to the Past.
Yeah, see, but I don't think much people will care about that game, though.
I think, but see, that's the thing about it. With Soul Blazer, I think people would be able to play a new Nintendo role-playing game that didn't get that much press. I think we all played a Link to the Past, so that's why I say no. And because of your rule, Adrian, and plus your rule, Adrian.
If we did
Adrian,
that with every single game, then it would be all these rare, not popular, good games that nobody would want to buy that thing for.
I think they would. I literally think they would, because everybody would complain, like, well, I already own most of these games on my past systems, even on my Wii U. So why would I play them on this mini Super Nintendo? That wouldn't make no sense. Me spending $60 on something like that wouldn't make no sense, because if we go to the normal same route of games that we know that we'll probably all choose, we've played these games before. Now, it'll be good for a younger generation, but I'm like, let's try to put some on some rare games from Nintendo that we've never played. And I think
anyone will buy that game that you just said.
Was Soul Blazer? Because
I've never heard of it.
Right, Soul Blazer was an RPG by Nintendo. And a lot of people didn't get a chance to play it. It was at the end of, I think, the Super Nintendo's life. And I'm just using that game
anyway,
as
example. We'll keep going on the list and come back to whatever, because we have to move on. There's a lot of games here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure the next one is going to be for everyone and a no from Eddie. Super Metroid.
How can you not?
Sure. I would say Super Metroid will be on there.
Okay. Earthbound?
I would say yes, Earthbound, and come to think of it, I'm surprised that given that they finally released Earthbound Zero in the U.S. A year or two ago, why they didn't put it on the NES Mini. That would have been a smart thing to do.
It will have been, but I think it's the same problem of not a lot of people know about Earthbound Beginnings to begin with, so it will have been, that another popular game could have gotten instead. However, I would have still liked to have Earthbound Beginnings on that NES Mini, but that's just me, basically.
Yeah, I think
we could have gotten rid of Simon's Quest off there and put Earthbound Beginnings on.
I think with the NES Mini, they were trying to put games that people haven't played in 20 years.
Yeah.
Earthbound Beginnings is a game nobody played until a year ago, you know? Yeah.
That's very true. That is very true. Mm-hmm. All right, so where do you stand on Earthbound on the Super Nintendo Mini?
I would say yes.
Yeah, you, Tony.
Oh, that has to be on there.
All right, what about you, Eddie?
No.
No? All right. Mm-hmm. Moving into the next game, Super Mario World. That's a yes right away from me.
Yeah.
Yes.
I would say yes.
Mortal Kombat?
Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
I would say Mortal Kombat 2, but not the first one, no. Because they didn't have blood on the first one. They had sweat.
Yeah, I remember.
That wouldn't be a good choice.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say any of the Mortal Kombats on the SNES Mini. I've always associated that series with the Genesis.
Two was the better version, because it almost was like the arcade version. And I think it sold more than the Genesis. That's when they put the ESRB ratings, like they finalized it. That's why I said 2 would probably been better, but no, the 1.
All right.
I would say no to any Mortal Kombat game. I don't even know if I would say yeah to any fighting game. That's hard.
Well, I will say yes to one fighting game, but we'll get to that one a little bit later. What about F-Zero?
Yes.
F-Zero?
Yeah.
Hell yes.
Yeah.
Honey?
I've never been... we've already been over this. I've never been a big fan of that series, and I still think that that game has to be on there.
All right. There we go. That's what I like to hear.
The downside is that one had no multiplayer.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was very... Yeah, that's the only downside of it, for sure. Yeah. Well, anyway, this game, again, I haven't heard of it. Sky Blazer. No idea what that is.
Sky Blazer, I know what it is. I would say yes. I think it's an RPG.
All right. What about you guys?
So it's an RPG?
I think so. Or
I've never heard of that one either.
Right. So would you say just no then, Tony?
I would say no because there's so many better RPGs I know that are good that I would say yes to. So I would say no to that one.
It looks like it's a platform game.
I give it the veto for the simple fact that for me putting this together is like building a nostalgia list, and I've got no nostalgia associated with it because I don't know it. That one's just off my radar completely.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
It's the same for me. I would like to try new games. However, I don't think this is the...
It's a platformer. Like,
pick 15 games for the Super Nintendo, it won't be one of my choices.
It's a platformer game by Sony.
I have no idea. Anyway, the next game on the list is Mega Man X.
Yeah.
That's a must for me.
Mm-hmm.
I'd say yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This game I play a little bit. I'm very indifferent towards it. Super Castlevania.
If we have to put a Castlevania on there, I guess, because it's better than... I forgot. What's the other one called where you play as Richter? Edward, you probably know the name, huh? That was on Super Nintendo?
Castlevania X.
Is it Dracula X?
Dracula X,
yeah. Yeah, but I have played Castlevania 4, and I don't like that Castlevania. There's many better Castlevania games than that one.
I think that one was trying to introduce Mode 7. I wouldn't put it. I wouldn't put it on there.
All right. What about you, Larry?
I'd let it ride. I think Castlevania belongs somewhere in the list of like every Nintendo platform at some point.
All right. Yeah. Like I said, I'm very indifferent towards it, so I just pass on it. I don't know. I kind of like the NES Castlevanias better. So, Yoshi's Island. I think that's a must.
Oh
yeah. The music alone in that game is so good that game has to be on there for me.
What about you, Larry?
Which one?
Yoshi's Island.
I wasn't big on the Yoshi stuff.
Yeah.
I could take it or leave it. Truthfully.
All right. So I'm gonna put a maybe on you then. The next one, another one that I've never heard, ActRaiser.
Yeah, ActRaiser.
Hell
yeah.
Yes!
Yes, that goes on.
ActRaiser is a cool game.
Yes.
It's a challenging game.
What is it about for those of us like me that don't know what it is?
You're a god that's kind of being resurrected, and it has a sim-based kind of adventure and a 2D action platform. So... it kind of switched between those modes, and the music in that game is amazing. It's like it's a real nice action game, like really challenging. I think you would get a lot of replay in that game because you get to design how you want the layout of the land to be. But once you get into like the platforming, you will see. You would hear how good the music is, how tight the control is, and you would just be like, wow, this is such a great action game.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And if you need to brush up, that's up on Virtual Console.
Yes.
And then go back and watch some Nick Arcade. That shit on Nick Arcade, too.
I wish Larry had to tell you that.
Yes.
Hey, Adrian, so Corey and Matt from Digital Nerds Advocate, they didn't know what, no, Matt knew what it was, but Corey didn't know what Nick Arcade was. And I almost fell out. I'm like, wait, you don't know about Nick Arcade?
Wow. Like, he's allowed to not know things. But anyway, moving on. I'll research that game later. I put a no on me, but we can go back to it. Chrono Trigger, I think that's a must as well on the Super Nintendo.
Oh, that's a must.
Yeah.
All right, this is the fighting game that I was mentioning before. I think Street Fighter 2 is one of the best Street Fighters. Maybe we'll put like Turbo instead of the regular one.
I would just do like the speed. I would probably do Super Street Fighter.
I would say,
yeah,
I would. Edward. If there's gonna be Street Fighter, it might as well be Super.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. I'm gonna edit this then.
Like put on the final version that had everything.
Remember they had Street Fighter Alpha 2 on the Super Nintendo?
Not that one.
No, but I was literally shocked that they did it. Yeah, I was just shocked that they did it. I'm like, wow.
Yeah.
All right, the next game is Super Mario Kart. Yay or nay?
I would say
how many are we at right now?
We will get there. Don't worry about it.
No.
Oh, don't worry about how many games we said yes.
Yeah, we'll erase them later and come back to the list. So you said no for Super Mario Kart.
I would say yes.
You will say yes. I would say yes.
That way, there's a multiplayer racer.
Yeah. What about you, Larry?
Oh yeah, I'm with Tony for the exact same reason. You know, F-Zero should be on there. But again, you know, it's single player. Mario Kart is a multiplayer racer, and it's a different flavor too.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Come on, agree. Now on this one, I'm kind of confused. Final Fantasy VI was what? Final Fantasy IV
three.
In the States?
It's Final Fantasy
I think it was
three.
Three.
Yeah, and that has to be on it.
All right. What about you, Tony? You think it should be on
Sam.
There?
Yeah.
Okay, Larry?
I didn't care, truthfully.
Yeah, I don't really care about Final Fantasy games either. Kirby's Dream Land 3.
No, I hate that game. I was so disappointed. I got that one on my Wii U, and it's not even on there anymore. I didn't like it.
Oh.
Yeah, I can skip it.
All right, Larry?
No, but that reminds me, I need to download Kirby 64 on my Wii.
Oh my gosh.
Right, the next one is something that I don't think it will really work because of the extra stuff you needed. Mario Paint.
Nah. Yeah, I don't extra know. Stuff or not, fuck it, no.
Nah, that's a big no for me as well. Pilot Wings.
Oh no, Pilot Wings you can skip also.
Yeah, if we're limited to 15, that game's not necessary.
Right?
No. Now, see, Star Fox is what you should put on there instead of Pilot Wings.
Right.
Yeah,
Star Fox should be on there.
Right? Earthworm Jim 2.
No.
I don't know if I'd put 2 on there without 1.
Yeah.
One is actually farther down below. I like 1 better, to be honest. Those games haven't aged well, though, so I don't know if I'll even put 1 in the list, to be honest.
If you've already got Mega Man X on the list, any other platform shooter I don't think is necessary.
Yeah.
Really.
Earthworm's another one that I really associate with the Genesis as well.
Yeah.
I
think it was better on the Genesis.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Secret of Mana?
Oh, yes.
I haven't played it, so I don't care.
Yes. You need to play it, Adrian. It needs to be on it, yes.
What about you, Tony?
Secret of Mana. I don't know, I think it's not as important as some other RPGs. Although it does have multiplayer, right, Edward?
Yeah, it's 3 players. That was the first multiplayer for RPGs.
Yeah, I'd say okay, fine. I would give that one a go ahead, and then no more RPGs after that.
Hey, what about you, Larry?
I'm kind of in the same boat there. It, you know, you've got a multiplayer RPG. That's a brilliant thing to have on there.
You guys have to remember something. For Secret of Mana to work on the Super Nintendo, you needed a multi-tap in order to connect three controllers.
Mm-hmm.
That's something that this console wouldn't probably have, though.
But if it's using the same method as the NES, and you're using the gamepad, it should be like the same thing with the remotes.
Maybe.
It could be done without a lot of difficulty.
Because the thing about it, how would you do? I can understand like F-Zero, but like how would you do like Mario Kart? Because I thought Mario Kart was four players.
No, it's only two.
It's only two for Bello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Super Mario Kart was only two player.
Yeah.
I thought it was four.
All right. I just want to take back my last statement of no more RPGs because there is one more that would have to be on there for me.
All right, I'm going to the list now. So the next one I think is the one either before or after this, which is Illusion of Gaia. Again, I haven't played it, so I don't care.
Yeah, I've never played that one.
Yeah, that's another Nintendo RPG.
So is that a yes or no?
I would pass on Illusion of Gaia. It's a good one, but I think Soul Blazer is the sequel to Illusion of Gaia.
All right, Larry?
Fuck it, don't care about it.
All right, so the next one, I know Larry and I don't care about it, which is Final Fantasy IV, which is God knows which number in Japan. Jay or Nay?
If you got six, you don't need four, I don't think. It was a great one, but...
I mean, if you already own the DS, you already played four. So I was skipping because I don't think four actually counts.
You assume so many things all the time, man.
What?
I haven't played it. I'm not about to guess.
I mean, all of this, like, because we didn't get Final Fantasy IV here.
Yeah, it was Final Fantasy II.
Well, either way, we skipped it. All right, Mega Man X2.
No.
Nah.
Barry?
Only one. Okay.
I've got Mega Man X, and I'm happy.
Yeah, I agree with the same. So Mega Man X3 is also out of the race. Now, you guys have to help me here. I remember there was a Breath of Fire on the Super Nintendo. I don't remember the number. So was it 1 and 2 or just 2?
It was 1 and 2.
1 and 2, I think. Yes. Was
all right, so yeah. For Breath of Fire 1, yay or nay?
Nah.
I would say yes.
I played the Game Boy Advance remake and I really liked it, so I'm gonna say yes to that one too.
And plus, this is by Capcom with Squaresoft publishing it, so it's kind of weird to have the first kind of, I guess, crossover developed game that I know of for the Super Nintendo. All
right. What about you, Larry?
It's more RPG that I don't give a shit about.
Alrighty. So, with that in mind, Breath of Fire 2, out. This is a game that I haven't heard of before. Demon's Crest.
Demon's Crest is so good.
It's a platformer game from Capcom in the realm of Ghosts and Goblins. Or Ghouls and Ghosts.
Yeah, it's kind of similar to Super Metroid, kind of.
I will be into that, to be honest, just by the Ghosts and Goblins description.
Yeah.
So I'm going to put a guess.
It's an awesome game.
Yeah, I will go for it because I didn't play it.
The Ghosts and Goblins mention interested me because I'm sitting here thinking I'm waiting for Ghosts and Goblins to show up on this list. You know, Super Ghouls and Ghosts or Super Ghosts and Goblins or whichever the fuck one it is. But, you know
what? Looking down on the list, nobody mentioned that.
Really?
Yeah. Well, but we can go we can go around that later. So Demon's Crest for you, is that a yes or no?
I don't know. I'm not familiar with it. But hearing Ghosts and Goblins and Super Metroid together has piqued my interest.
It sounds kind of awesome, right? Yeah. I put a game to me, too, so...
Larry, finally, I can recommend you a game, and that's Demon's Crest, man. You're going to love it, I think.
This is a really good game.
I have it up on Virtual Console, and I missed it.
It's on Virtual Console, on Wii U.
Is it? Excellent. That's how I can find it.
All right. Well, you know what? Whenever Tony puts a seal of approval on a game, that's high remarks. So
it's hard though, just so you guys.
Oh yeah, it's in the world of Ghosts and Goblins. You should know.
Hey,
that.
Yeah, we play Mighty Number 9. Nothing else is.
Oh coming. Yeah. So yeah, we're good.
Yeah. The next game that I have here, it's one of my favorite RPGs ever, which is Super Mario RPG: Legend of the Seven Stars.
That was the other one I was going to say has to be on there.
Yeah, it has to.
Barry?
I can go along with that.
Cool. Now, this one, I know it's a compilation of games that are already on the NES Mini, but Super Mario All-Stars? Would you guys put that on the list?
No. No. No way.
All right, so we're going to skip it there. TMNT, Turtles in Time. That's a big
yes.
For me.
That's an automatic yes.
Larry?
You know, I'm going to say no.
Really? How come?
Because there are other beat-em-ups for the Super, and I've got one in particular in my head that I would rather see on there. And on top of that, my favorite Turtles game was not Turtles in Time. It was Turtles 3 on the NES, The Manhattan Project.
Really? That one I haven't played. I didn't play that one.
Manhattan Project was my jam.
Interesting. Well, all right. The next one is, I don't remember this one, Kirby's Curse.
What was it?
Kirby's Curse?
Yeah. Like, Curse as, like Rainbow Curse.
Oh, Kirby's Dream Course?
Yeah. I don't remember
that one.
It's
like the golf game with Kirby.
Yeah, that's the golf one.
Yeah, it's pretty good, actually. But hard, too.
Would you guys put a guess on that or no?
I probably wouldn't.
All right, Barry?
I would say yes, just because that was really the Kirby game for the Super Nintendo, because you know Dream Land on Super Nintendo not so much. Kirby's Dream Course though was fun, and it's Kirby.
It is fun. It is fun, and it has two player, like competitive. Yeah.
All right. You'll change yours to yes?
Yeah, I would say yeah, because that game, it has a lot of good stuff.
I'll still say no.
What about Tetris Attack?
Oh, yes. I've been dying for that game to be on freaking Virtual Console or something. I know it's not going to happen, but I'd way rather play that than Pokemon Puzzle League or Puzzle... whatever, it's on DS. That was the one, man. That one's so good.
Oh,
I love Tetris games, so it's always a joke for me.
Tony really just wants to play Puzzle, Puzzle, Puzzle.
I'm going back to listen to that tonight. That was so funny.
You're welcome.
All right, so Larry, Eddie, yes or no for Tetris Attack?
Yeah, I would. I haven't played that one, but I'm interested in playing it.
I'm going to say no, because there's only three Tetris games that matter to me, and that ain't one of them.
All right. Now, the Donkey Kong Country series.
Oh,
1,
no.
2, and 3.
No.
Enough for all of them for you? All right. Where were you, Larry?
I want Donkey Kong Country 1, and the rest can fuck off.
All right. Tony?
1.
I would say 2, if any of them, but really I'm not a fan of that series at all.
Alright, I would just put 1 as well, so... alrighty. Zombies Ate My Neighbors.
Yes.
I don't care. I don't care about that either.
I would.
I've never played it.
Yeah. Nope.
Eh.
Alright, so that's... okay, for Eddie, and no. Right, NBA Jam. I really like NBA Jam.
Oh, yes. I'm sorry if I'm getting happy. I was just thinking about that game.
What about you, Tony?
Not a big sports fan. I would say no. I'd rather see a different game on there.
Yep. Larry?
Actually, it's very arcadey. I think you like it, Tony.
I'm not a big sports fan. That being said, I like NBA Jam. On top of that, though, I think it belongs on the Genesis Mini.
Yeah, I kind of agree with that.
And plus, you can play as Bill Clinton, like a president in the basketball game.
Yeah, that's not a fun point, dude. Anyway, Super Punch-Out.
Oh, Super Punch-Out for sure, yeah.
What you need for that game is three words. He's on fire!
Right. Super Punch-Out, yes. That's automatic.
Yeah, I kind of agree with that, too. This game, I think, is going to be a big no for most of us. Gradius 3.
Nah.
No, because that one got a lot of slowdown problems.
Yeah. Now, this is a game that our friends in the UK sent it to us. Apparently, they don't know if we got it here or not. I've never heard of it, but it's called Terranigma.
Yeah, we did get it.
Terranigma?
Yeah. It's a All game. Right. It plays like Contra. It's a Contra game.
I don't know. I put no for me because I've never heard of it.
Me neither.
Yeah, you'll have to look at it. I would still say no because Contra 3 is better, but it's a really good game. It's very challenging.
All right, what about you, Larry?
I'm not familiar. Just on nostalgia, I'll say no. But you know that's possible to change if I ever played it and went, ooh, cool. So.
This is another game that I've never heard of before, Tales of Phantasia.
It's from the Tales game, so like Tales of Symphonia, Tales of Graces F. Like, so if you're into the Nelco Tales game, that was kind of the one for Super Nintendo. I didn't see it in stores, I think I would say no.
Alright. Tony?
Never played it before. I would probably say no too.
Barry? That's an RPG, so you probably don't care.
I don't care, but for what it's worth, I actually kind of like the Tales series. Not enough to get like all hardcore on it, but if it was the only thing around to play, I wouldn't bitch.
Alright.
The Tales games were fun.
Right.
I just think it's better spent.
Yeah, exactly. So the next one, I think we kind of said no already, which is Earthworm Jim 1. I think we kind of all skipped on it.
Yeah, that one fits better on the Genesis.
Yeah. What about Battletoads?
Is it? I think it's Battletoads versus Double Dragon.
And that's where I was going to go with the beat 'em up was Battletoads Double Dragon. Don't get me wrong, I'll get down on some straight up Battletoads too, though.
All right, so but for these Battletoads, do we say just now or?
Yeah, I would say no.
I jam on that. Yes.
Yeah, I would say no.
All right, another sports game, Super Baseball 2020. I don't care.
No.
I'm good.
Right, what about NBA Hank Time? No idea.
It's almost like NBA Jam.
But
NBA Jam is a better game then.
But Hank Time is in the same realm. They ended up changing the name for it later on. Because it's by Midway. So, no, I wouldn't say no. I mean, I would say yes. I'll say no.
Okay. Larry?
No, I'd kick it to the curb.
All right. The Lion King, I also remember this game on the Genesis, but a lot of people remember it on the Super Nintendo. So, what do you guys say?
I used to love that game, but... probably because I didn't have anything better to play that I hadn't played it yet, so I would probably still say no now.
Yeah, I'll pass, no.
Right, Larry?
No, if you were going to put a Disney platformer on there from back in the day, I would say Aladdin.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, the last game that someone on the group sent to us was Lester the Unlikely. I haven't heard of this game at all.
No, that's a joke.
Oh, is it?
That has to be a joke suggestion.
I have no idea about that, so...
You know what game we missed, though, that should have been on that list was fucking Bubsy.
I don't care about Bubsy enough, to be honest.
A game that I beat all in one sitting.
Right, so let me just delete all the games that we said no to. Which is quite a few.
Can't believe no one didn't put Tiny Toons on there.
Wait, what was that?
Tiny Toons by Konami.
I remember that on the Genesis as well.
Yeah, I remember on the Super Nintendo. It was a very popular platforming game.
What'd you say, Looney Tunes?
Tiny Toons.
Tiny Toons.
Oh, is it Buster Bust Loose?
Is it?
I think so.
The one where he can, like, run up the walls? That game is awesome.
Yeah.
I love that game.
Because I know they did one for the Super, one for the NES, but I remember this Super Nintendo one.
Alright. So we got our list pared down there, Adrian?
I'm still working on it. You guys just bent for a little bit more.
Batman Returns was a good one by Konami.
Batman Returns is awesome. I love that game.
I love that one.
Or did any of you guys play X-Men Age of... what was it called? Mutant Apocalypse?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That one was good.
Yeah? That game... Yeah, what was awesome about that was, like, it was a beat-em-up, but to do the X-Men's, like, special moves, because it was made by Konami, it was all fighting game inputs, so you would do, like, a fireball to do Cyclops to shoot his, like, optic beams.
Which was pretty cool.
That actually sounds pretty awesome.
Which I wonder why they didn't bring the X-Men arcade game, because they brought, like, Turtles in Time, Sunset Riders, like, they brought some of their arcade games to the Super Nintendo. I wonder why they didn't just bring that one here.
The X-Men arcade was not made by Capcom.
No, it was made by Konami.
Yeah, it was made by Konami, but that X-Men game that I was talking about is made by Capcom.
Oh, because you said Konami, that's why.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, you said Konami.
Haha. Also, a really good fighting game is Ninja Turtles.
Tournament Fighters.
Tournament Fighters.
Yeah,
I think that's a better fighting game than freaking Street Fighter 2, but that's just me.
Yeah, I had that for Super Nintendo and then got it for $20 for the Sega Genesis in the bargain bin. Yeah.
You probably still pay too much on that one. I think the Sega Genesis one is not very good.
Dude, I ended up getting Rama Half Hard Battle for the Super Nintendo when I should have bought Snatcher for the Sega CD, even though I didn't own the Sega CD. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
KB Toy Store.
Eddie, quick question. Did you say yes or no on Earthbound?
No.
Okay, cool.
I said no.
Just want to confirm that quickly.
I'm just going to put out there, by the way, the reason I said no to Tetris Attack, the three Tetris games that do matter were Tetris on the Game Boy, Tetris on the NES, and Tetris DS.
Tetris DS is awesome.
Oh, that game is...
Oh, yeah. Every other can shag off.
But Tetris Attack isn't like actual Tetris. I know that's the name, but it's... Do you know like Pokemon Puzzle League? Do you know that game?
Or Panda Puzzle League? And if I wanted to play a game like that, I would play Meteos.
Oh, you are so wrong for that one. Meteos is so good. Love the music in that game.
Hell yes, Meteos had a bomb-ass soundtrack.
Wasn't that Cute Entertainment?
Tetris Attack had a good soundtrack, too.
Was that Mizuguchi's? Oh, wonder. I have to look that one up.
Now see, Meteos is a game that needs to come out on the virtual console on the Wii U. Because they're putting out some of the old DS games. That'd be a good one.
Right.
What will we get down on that?
Meteos.
Oh, Meteos. Such a good game.
I can't believe no one didn't even say Star Fox. I would have chose that.
Oh, I thought we all said yeah for Star Fox.
We said yes for Star Fox.
Oh, I didn't hear it on the list. I don't remember hearing it on the list.
Yeah, you even said yes.
Oh.
Star Fox was like right after Pop Wings.
Oh, okay. That's probably why.
Exactly. Alright, sorry, I'm almost done here. Oh, just messed up some of the values there. So I think I got it right now.
I know R-Type wouldn't be on there. Cause I know R-Type was like a slow game. I know that was problematic.
See that? I would totally put R-Type.
Oh, hey. There was no SimCity, huh?
Oh, mm-mm. That game is confused.
No, actually, like SimCity.
All right, so we fell short by three games. So the games we have on the list so far are Super Mario World, Super Mario RPG, F-Zero, Mega Man X. This one was a maybe for you, Larry. So, Yoshi's Island. Still a no or a yes?
Let it be.
All right.
Yay! That'll work.
Some of the best bus battles.
Next one is Chrono Trigger. Super Street Fighter. Super Metroid. Super Punch-Out. Star Fox. Secret of Mana. And Demon's Crest. From the games that are on the short list... that we can still add to that. Remember, we need three. So I'm just going to read them over, and you guys get the final vote. All right, so Tetris Attack.
I would say yeah.
For the final three, you will put Tetris Attack there.
Yeah.
Okay.
We need a puzzle game, right?
I guess so. You said no, Larry. What about you, Eddie? Would you still put it on the list?
I will put it on the list. We need a puzzle game on there. So I will put it on.
Okay. So I'm going to just put it down here. Super Mario Kart.
How did that not make the list?
Because Eddie said no.
I still say no.
God damn it.
I think
it should go down there.
I honestly think to God that it should be there.
I think there's better Mario Karts in. I just don't.
Not on the Super Nintendo, there's not.
You know what? This is the Mario Kart that started the Mario Kart series, so I think it definitely should go on the list.
Yeah, but I don't think it's that popular or memorable.
Fun.
Huh?
All right. The last four we only have one pick. Is A Link to the Past, Earthbound, ActRaiser, and Turtles in Time.
Oh my God! Those are all good games. How did they not get on the list already?
If I can't get Ninja Turtles, I will go ActRaiser. I don't think Link to the Past and Earthbound. People play them too much. I think you know those are all. Those are just easy picks, so that's why I said no. Plus people play them so much, so that's why I say ActRaiser.
This list doesn't have a Zelda game, so my vote is gonna go to Zelda. Okay, Tony, what about you?
You know, I don't think I would buy that thing of Link to the Past, Turtles in Time, and what was the other one? Not ActRaiser. What was the other option?
Earthbound.
And oh my God. What are you doing to me, Adrian?
I'm sorry.
All right, now, you know what? Let's do this properly. Right. I reset the thing. We have three spots.
Damn, you know, it's really hard. Put away all the games on there. Throw all of them on there and then give me R-Type to boot.
You know what? Yeah, it's correct. It's our list. All these games go in there and we'll pay in $75 instead of $60.
Yeah, I would do it.
See, you can't break the rules like that.
I can do whatever the hell you want. It's our show.
It's supposed to be 15. It's supposed to be 15 games.
Well, now it's 20.
Shut up. Now it's 18, actually. But yes.
Then we might as well just kept it at the 30 list, Adrian.
That's fine. It's fine. It's our show. We can do whatever we want.
Oh man, I love it. I love it.
You know, Adrian can't stick to his own gameplay. I'm like, you made the rules. We're just trying to follow the rules.
Exactly. I just broke them for my own advantage. You know what? I'll be 100% honest. If I were to chop two games off this list to bring it down to 16 instead of 18, will be Tetris Attack and Act Racer. I will probably just kill those two.
I couldn't have Earthbound on Link to the Past only because they've been played so much. I'm like, they've been discussed so much, and I would rather have something that people haven't played on there.
The average human being would like to play a Zelda game over a Tetris game.
I highly doubt it.
About what games do you want to go back and play again?
Right, and people have people have a lot of access to the Link to the Past. A lot of people don't really have that much access to Act Racer besides the virtual console. You know,
because people
Link
don't
to the
care,
Past,
Eddie.
But Link to the Past has been on so many systems, so that's why I say Act Racer would be a better choice than Link to the Past because everybody played it. Like how many people are really gonna go to the Link to the Past?
Weird. How many consoles has Super Mario Brothers been on, and it's on that NES Mini?
Yep.
Well, all three of them games. That's their flagship game. And you know what? And I didn't even know why they put it on there, but I guess because it's their mascot, and that's what Nintendo's kind of known for. I understand why they would put it. Trust me, I wouldn't put it on there. Heck, I would at least keep Mario Brothers 2 on there, because we're not going to get that kind of style of a game again.
Hold on. From all three Mario Bros. Games, you will put only Mario 2?
Yeah.
That's insane.
Why? It changed
because
the whole...
Mario 1 is the better game.
No, Mario 2 is better. How many people would have played all 32 levels of Mario Bros. 1 that would not do the cheat code? Or do the
it doesn't matter
do
how
the
you
100
play
man
it.
Thing.
It's,
but see,
it's just the
that's
game.
The thing. But see, that's the thing about it. How many people do you know has played all 32 levels, have not did the cheat code, have not did the 99 man trick on the third level? Like, how many people do you know and haven't discovered Minus World? Like, those four things that stand out. Like, how many people have really, really played the whole thing for 32 levels? Because I played the whole game before.
That's not the point. It's just the better, the most recognizable game. Nobody really cares about Mario 2.
A lot of people care about Mario.
It's not
Games
even really
2.
A Mario game.
It's not really a Mario game. Yeah,
but you know what? A lot of people, when they play in a Mario
I'm
game,
sorry,
music,
Edward, I'm sorry.
All right,
sorry, let's go with Mario
Bros. Let's bring it back because this show is going on for too long. And I had to go to sleep like an hour ago. Anyway,
you should pull the light out.
This list
is out of your blinds there.
Sorry?
So it can't be that light. I still see lights coming out of your blinds.
Right.
Yeah, but I have to wake up at 4 in the morning though.
You'll be fine.
No, I won't. I never am. But anyway, so the list right now is 18 games. We'll discuss this some more off the show and get back to everyone next week.
Can we just do like, or you know what, I'll post like a final 15 or something of mine, just like in the Facebook group.
Oh, post it on the post it on the main NBC group. I'm pretty sure people will probably vote.
NBC there. Group? I would put it on the World 1-1 group.
Right.
Oh yeah, whichever. Put it in all the groups.
All right, fine. I'll put it in all the groups.
anyway, so we have one more item in the agenda. Larry, why don't you take it away with your commercial idea? I just sighed in disappointment.
And by the way, I was telling Eddie, I got a friend that's doing film school. He's just the person we need to talk to film this shit.
Oh God.
So I was telling Adrian the other night in our group chat that we keep going. I said, you know, Adrian, I had a dream about you the other night, and he messages me back. He's like, oh shit, now what? And all of us said, so in this dream, it was a close up of you in your face and your wind's blowing in the hair and it's all sexy and manly. And the camera pans out and there you're standing holding all powerful, like a nice, like glass bottle of maple syrup. And you just stand there. And in your sexiest, manliest voice, we hear you go, pure Canada, pure maple. End commercial right there.
Is he in a lumberjack outfit?
Hell yes. He's got the suspenders, but no shirt, though.
Of course.
He's got the pants and the suspenders and no shirt, but he's got the hat, though. Yeah. Totally.
Oh, my God.
Pure maple.
I think like the lumberjack is the Canadian equivalent of like, you know, the sexy fireman thing in America.
Anyway, that was all the items on our main agenda for this episode. Before we go and start doing our plugs, I just want to say a few words. So today, every podcast records early that the day it drops. That's just a fact. People need some time to edit like podcasts and like put some music if they want, or mute curse words or whatever. Everyone does it. We do it as well. So I'm going to burst
the bubble here.
Yeah, well, no, we don't beep anything. We just put some music on and cut things together. But anyway, so we're recording on July 19, 2016 today, which is a Tuesday. Yeah, it's a Tuesday. I almost forgot. I thought it was a Monday. Today is the birthday of someone that was very special to me. However, she died in a car accident a couple of years ago, and she will have been 25 now, which is really sad that she went so young in her life. I just want to leave everyone with a couple of words, basically saying, hey, if you're driving, like, be careful. Don't use your phone. Don't try to put on makeup. Don't try to just change music if it's very busy street or whatever. Don't run. Like, what's the point of speeding to begin with? Don't Pokemon Go and drive either. That's just stupid. Why would you do it? Just, you know, be careful when you're in the road.
Be attentive.
Because if something happens to you, it's the people that love you who are hurt the most. So I lost someone very special, and today's her birthday, and I just did a bunch of stuff that reminded me of her, and I just want to leave everyone with those words. But now it's time to end the show. Thank you everyone for listening. Let's just go around the table. Actually, I'm gonna get a coffee while Eddie just plugs his stuff in here. Yeah. Eddie, take it away.
Okay, I guess. So you guys can follow us on Facebook for World 1-1 Podcast on Facebook. You can email the show. We want to hear your list for the top 15 games or even 30 games for a Super NES Mini. Also, we still looking out for your guys' Smash Brothers arcade list. And also, let us know what media helps you relax, go to sleep. You can send all those answers to world11podcast@gmail.com. That's W11PODCAST@gmail.com. You can hear my show, Optional Opinion, on SoundCloud, iTunes, and Google Play. Also on the Anonymous Radio Network, podbean.com. Sorry about that. Where you'll also be able to hear World 1-1 on SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play also. Larry's going to tell you guys about archive.org, where you can also hear World 1-1 podcast. He'll give you more information about that. You can follow me on Twitter at ThatRetroCode, ThatRetroCode. Next week, after this episode comes out, you can check IGN.com under anime, E-N-I-M-E, for a feature for Optional Opinion, where my theme is Why Racism Doesn't Exist in Video Games. And in the first week of August, I should be having my Fire Emblem episode out that week too. So do check in to that. Also check in to skirmishfrogs.com, skirmishfrogs.com, and you can read my series The Moment. The last one that I put up was The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD, or actually The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, but I used the pictures from the HD version, so do check that out. And you can listen to the Digital Nerds Advocate, the DNA Power Block, our all Nintendo show with Corey DeRick and Adrian Nieto. You can hear me on DNA DualShock coming soon. Hope that I'll be on Connected. And you can hear me on the latest episode of DNA Nerds Go Wrong. Also, Adrian and I appeared on the Phoenix Nerd Overdrive, or Nerd Overdrive, with Lee, Rebecca, and Ray. So do check them out. Also, they're doing something special for Extra Life. So you can go to their page, nerdoverdrive.com, I think, or just check Edward Varnell, my page on Facebook, where you can friend me and check out more information with that. I'm going to hand it over to Big Papa himself, Mr. Larry Giver.
Yeah, I ain't got shit to plug. All my shit's already up on the Facebook page, up on Xbox Live. I finally got around to putting up my Wii U and my 3DS friend code stuff. It's up there. We finally got our shit together and we're up on archive.org. We've got the link up on the Facebook page as well. In the little about section. And I drop a link every week when I post up a new episode as well. Some nifty features is, you know, if you're just joining us and you want to be able to listen to all the back episodes and download them, there's a nice little download all button that'll let you grab everything all at once. Other than that, I got nothing. I'm tired. I'm burnt. It puts the aloe on its skin.
And rest the lotion. And we want to thank our special guest.
I feel so bad for you, Larry.
Hold on, Eddie. Oh. I'll get to that.
I thought that Adrian's just in the dark.
Yeah,
you are too. And Tuna Cycle is available for iTunes and Google Play. So you guys pick it up. Support the Frozen Machine also.
That's what I was going to say. Just go to thefrozenmachine.com. Follow us there. Don't follow me personally because I don't really matter that much. Maybe in Instagram. I do post a lot of stupid things on Instagram. So maybe follow my Instagram. Thank you, Tony, for joining us. I know you're always very busy, so it's awesome that we had you here today. And thank you also, Larry and Eddie, as always, for joining us. And I think with this, the train wreck is over. Thank you everyone for listening, and goodbye.
Everybody have a safe weekend.
Did you hear that thud? Did you hear it? I heard it. You know what that was?
That was
the sound of everyone's panties dropping because Tony was on the show.
Ooh.
Oh god.
Penny drop. So everybody, we'll see you next week on World 1-1 Podcast. Bye.
Bye. I'm just so tired.
show.